the station on your side. This is Wavy News 10.
Significantly cooler today, and it cools down even more tomorrow. We'll track those temperatures coming up.
Friends have placed flowers here near the site of a deadly attack on an ODU student. Hear how they're remembering them and what we know about this case so far. Next.
A Gloucester man was riding his bike and he was run off the road by a driver. Hit so bad he broke bones in his back, but the driver kept going. State police are looking for that driver tonight. I'm Ann McNamara. I'll have more on the story.
I've been to wrecks. I've been to fires. But that place was wrapped up with blood.
10 on your side helps keep a cold case alive.
The choices ahead will define our defense institutions for the years to come.
Translation, big cuts are expected for the military. What's on the block and what does it mean for Hampton Roads? Some answers straight ahead.
And Chopper 10 is live in the skies above Hampton Roads to give you an exclusive view of the news. We have a lot of news to get to this afternoon, but we want to say thank you for joining us for our first Wavy News 10 at 4 o'clock newscast. Good afternoon. I'm Anita Blanton.
And I'm Stephanie Harris. We hope you're as excited as we are about this extra hour of news from the station that you have come to trust. We're on your side, tracking all the breaking news as it happens here now at 4 o'clock as well. So let's get right to it. Police arrested two men in connection with a deadly attack on an ODU student. 20-year-old Paul Johnson died Sunday after police say someone beat him in the head.
I'm Erin Kelly, live in Norfolk. This is where police say it all happened. This was early Sunday morning, and according to witnesses, there was an argument of some sort, and someone went up behind that victim, 20-year-old Paul Johnson. Police say he was beaten in the back of the head, and he later died at the hospital. Now, police say they are expecting officers to bring 21-year-old David Grimm Jr. down from Prince William County, where he was arrested. He will be charged with second-degree murder. As for 20-year-old Christopher Chase Johnson of Woodbridge. He, according to police, turned himself into the Norfolk Police Department. He is out of jail on bond. He will be charged with misdemeanor assault. And we did talk to a friend of the victim, and that she told us that she did not want to show her face on camera, but she did put down these flowers all along the street here. Take a listen to what she said about the victim.
He's a really amazing person. He made everyone laugh. He played the drums. He was really amazing at the drums. And I know his family, like all of his five brothers, looked up to him a lot, and a lot of people here at ODU.
Now, Paul Johnson was a math major, a sophomore here at ODU. And ODU tells us that the suspects in this case were not students here. Coming up at 5, you're going to hear from a friend of the victim who was with him at the hospital the day he died. Live in Norfolk tonight, Erin Kelly, 10 on your side.
Thank you, Erin. And we can show you the mugshot now of the woman in the Norfolk City Jail right now who's in there for killing a man on the Shore Drive over the weekend. You probably heard us reporting on this story. Police have charged 40-year-old Rashonda Walker, who you see here, with murder. Detectives say she killed 25-year-old Alfonso Creekmore. Officers found him dead behind a hotel around 4 a.m. on Saturday morning. Creekmore's mother told 10 on your side Walker is her son's ex-girlfriend. Police have not confirmed their relationship or released a motive right now. Also today, Detective Misty Hawley with the Portsmouth Police released this mugshot of the man arrested for a hit and run in Portsmouth. Detectives say 36-year-old Hector Enriquez was driving under the influence when he hit a 13-year-old on Greenwood Drive this weekend, and then he tried to drive off. So police say Enriquez crashed into a parked car here at the scene that you're looking at. The teen should be okay.
It's not something military families around here want to hear. Some big cuts may be on the way, and for most of us, we've never seen a military this small before.
We chose further reductions in troop strength and force structure in every military service, active and reserve, in order to sustain our readiness and technological superiority.
But it would still be the smallest force since World War II. Also on the chopping block, the Air Force will eliminate an entire class of attack jet, and the Navy could ultimately lose an aircraft carrier. Now, these are just some of the key recommendations Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel will make to the president for future defense budgets beginning in 2016. 10 on your side, military reporter Art Kahn has been following these developments out of the Pentagon today. Art joins us now with the latest. Art, Now, these cuts are going to impact both the national defense and, of course, our local economy.
Absolutely, and the two do go hand in hand, don't they? You know, Secretary Hagel announced these proposals as part of a five-year plan that will boost defense spending by a total of $115 billion over sequestration spending caps. Now, that statement taken by itself sounds pretty good. But even though that calls for increased spending, there will still have to be significant cuts like the ones you alluded to, cuts that could impact both the national defense and us here in Hampton Roads. Now, this is a complex issue that looks at spending over the next 5 years. I'm working to identify the main areas of concern for Hampton Roads, and there is a reason for this area to be concerned, believe me. I'll have that for you and our viewers coming up later in this show.
All right, Art, we will look for that. Thank you so much. The Navy relieved of command one of the highest ranking officers at Joint Expeditionary Base Little Creek Fort Story. The installation's commander relieved was the Command Master Chief Yves Renault, and reassigned him to Navy Region Mid-Atlantic in Norfolk. Ten on your side asked why this happened. The Navy would not elaborate. A new CMH is acting until a permanent one is found.
Well, most of us realized we had a little spring-like weekend. That's why I have all of this going on.
Allergies.
For my allergies, yeah. It was great while it lasted, though, for a lot of people.
Not for you, but for the rest of us. At least the sun is out for now. The chill, though, is going to be back. Mm. And some of us may see, dare I say, snowflakes in the next couple of days.
Yeah, well, winter isn't letting us go just yet. Meteorologist Stephanie Savona joins us at 4 with a look at the evening forecast. And what's this about the snowflakes?
We do have some snowflakes in the forecast as we head toward the middle of the work week. Hard to believe after we've seen 60s and 70s over the past 6 to 7 straight days in a row. Now, today, it has been much cooler. At least we've had the sunshine, though, helping to warm us up. Mostly clear skies as we look outside toward the Lynn Haven Inlet. You can see not a cloud in the sky there. 24-hour temperature change showing that we're about 10 to 20 degrees cooler than where we were at this exact time yesterday. Check out the difference in temperatures across the metro. Upper 40s right now, Hampton, Norfolk International, Virginia Beach, but 50s and 60s if you go 10 miles inland. And why that's happening is we have these winds out of the west and northwest warming up those inland spots. But Hampton, Norfolk International, Virginia Beach, your wind is off the water. That's why temperatures have been a good 10 degrees cooler. Water temperatures in the lower 40s at this time. Your commute forecast as you head home from work, if you're watching us online on wavy.com before you leave, 53 degrees, mostly clear, mild winds out of the north at 5 to 15 miles per hour. And tomorrow morning, morning rush looks good. Colder, you will want to take that heavier jacket because we're looking at temperatures in the lower 30s, upper 20s inland. But Wednesday morning, that's when your commute could get a little messy. We have our latest computer model showing the rain and the snow that we're expecting. You won't want to miss that. That's coming up in a couple of minutes.
All right, thank you, Tiffany. She talked about our commute forecast. Let me show you what's happening for your commute out there on your roadways right now. As you can see, there's a lot of green, so things aren't looking too terribly bad. But let's zoom into the areas where we are going to see some problems right here on your screen. I'm going to look at what these areas are that are blinking right now so you can see them. All right, so we have an accident that happened earlier on I-564 eastbound between gates 3A at that Ballinger Boulevard and Granby Street, so you might still be seeing a slowdown there. Also, another one here, accident left lane blocked on I-264 westbound between Berkeley and Court Street. So those are a couple of areas that might give you some problems if you're out there on the roadways. Let's zoom in for those of you who are maybe going in this direction here toward Norfolk, 6 minutes down to 33 miles per hour. If you're coming in here, you can see there's some orange there, which means that your speeds are definitely getting a little bit slower as you're going into the a downtown tunnel here, and you can see right there as you get toward this area, there's more yellow on the screen. Now, here's a look at how things are shaping up. Definitely, you're going to have some slowdowns while you're out there on the roadways, but that's pretty much expected at this time of the evening and throughout your evening commute. I'll continue to keep you updated on what's happening out there on the roadways. Steph?
All right, thanks, Anita. Still ahead on Wavy News 10 at 4. A hit-and-run investigation in Gloucester County. Hear what the victim's wife said a driver did after hitting her husband. And we found this video from the other side of the country of water gushing high in the sky. We'll tell you what caused this.
And a cold case, three people killed inside a grocery store. The crime still haunts the local town 20 years later. A first responder is sharing chilling details.
And a live shot from Chopper 10 at 4 o'clock. This is a live shot of the Navy base. If you can make it up, make it out there. It is beautiful. Chopper 10's up there so we can break away to any breaking news we have during this 4 o'clock newscast and beyond. Stay with us.
From the station on your side, you're watching WAVY News 10 at 4.
You've got an auto approval flim flam.
I hate flim flammers.
They said I was approved. I wasn't approved.
It's because of my credit.
I couldn't hear you. I was too busy printing out your online approval with a great price from Drive Time. Now that's the real deal.
With an appeal, you can feel.
Like a banana peel on a cut that won't heal.
Save yourself. Get a real online approval first at DriveTime.com.
Can you see us?
Are you there?
We're breaking up.
Is it you or is it me?
Wait, no, dude, I'm lagging. Huh? Is it you or is it me?
Why is it so slow? Is it you or is it me?
If you're not on 100% fiber optics, it's you. Verizon Fios is 100% fiber optic. Cox isn't. So you can video chat smoother, game with less lag time, and upload a 5-minute HD video in 20 seconds. That's 5 times faster than Cox. That's why nothing compares to Fios, America's fastest, most reliable internet. Rated number one by PC Magazine 7 years in a row. Switch to Fios today and join the millions who experience the internet the way it's supposed to be. Getting the difference 100% fiber optics makes?
I love you too.
That's powerful.
Get a Fios triple play online for just $89.99 a month with a 2-year price guarantee and no annual contract. Plus, get a free speed upgrade to 50 meg internet for 2 years and switch with the confidence of a worry-free guarantee. Visit Verizon.com/superspeeds today to get America's fastest, most reliable internet.
Your mornings are important. That's why you trust the only station on your side. Always looking out for you. WAVY News 10 Today, your number one source in the morning for over 2 decades.
You've seen him take down the bad guys on NBC's Law & Order SVU.
Now he's taking on the Hampton Roads show.
Danny Pino makes a special visit.
Join us Wednesday at 11 a.m. on WAVY TV 10.
We salute Gladys Schuster Carter from the 6888 Central Postal Directory Battalion, the only African-American female unit during World War II to get mail to soldiers at the front.
Brought to you by Macari, Rosado, Spencer, and Balaban, attorneys at law.
The stories that impact you
are on at 5.
Investigations.
Tell me about Mr. Underwood.
Breaking news.
We have just arrived on the scene.
Changing conditions. WAVY News 10, weeknights beginning at 5.
It's one sight that you'll never forget. It's horrible. You can't fathom what happened. Everybody here knew everybody that was in there. It's still on everybody's mind in town right now.
10 on Your Side helps keep a cold case alive. Tonight on WAVY News 10 at 6.
Back on WAVY News 10 at 4 with an unsolved murder in a small town.
And tonight, WAVY News takes you inside this 20-year investigation.
I've been to wrecks, I've been to fires, but that place was wrapped up with blood. So a lot of those folks that were shot or the one that was stabbed, they didn't die instantly. They bled out. We're a small town. So you can imagine what the talk of the town was for years. Especially everybody here knew everybody that was in there.
That was the voice of Windsor's Joe Alexander. Alexander was part of the rescue squad on June 6, 1993. That's when a suspect went into a grocery store, bound 6 employees up with duct tape. They were put into piles, and the suspect fired right into those stacks. 3 people were killed. The suspect has never been caught. I'm Jason Marks, live here in Edit Bay 15 here at the WAVY Studios. This is Drew Smith. He's editing our report that will air tonight on WAVY News 10 at 6:15. But coming up on WAVY News 10 at 5, you'll actually hear why investigators and some of the people in the town believe that suspect who did that brutal crime, could be from right here in Hampton Roads. That's coming up in about an hour on Wavy News 10 at 5. We'll see you then.
Jason put a lot of hard work into that, so we'll see him shortly with more on that. But let's take a look at your 10 time saver traffic alert for you, giving you a look at some of our VDOT cameras. Here's I-64 at the high-rise bridge.
Yeah, looks like things are moving pretty well right there at this time. We are out there looking for trouble spots for you. I-264 at East City Hall Avenue there in Norfolk. Also, things are looking pretty good.
Yeah, for now. We know that area especially will definitely get more crowded as time goes on. Here's I-64 at Bay Avenue. We're going to keep our eyes on things. We know you're waiting for folks to get home, or maybe you're getting ready to get out on the roadways. We'll keep you covered. Let's talk about our forecast, too.
I just can't get that word out of my head. Snow.
I know. Oh, I mean, after seeing the
60s. Winter this week.
Yeah. And it's back to reality after we saw the 70s this weekend. Yeah. A lot of folks out there enjoying the weather, opening the windows, saving on the heat.
Going out without a coat.
Right, right. Mm-hmm. Take that coat back out of the closet. You may have needed the light jacket today because it wasn't too bad, but it was much cooler than what we saw this past weekend. Temperatures today topping out in the low to mid 50s. It was a little bit warmer across those inland locations. And like the title suggests, it is back to winter this week. We're going to be continuing the pattern that we've seen this past winter really dominate. So we have warm air to our south. This is what it was this past weekend. Here's the setup here. We have the jet stream off to our north. And then as we head into this upcoming work week, we had that cold front move through yesterday. And that colder air is just going to seep in from Canada, and it's going to really stay in place as we head into the next several days. So we're looking at another cold stretch for at least the next 5 to 7 days. And you can see the outline of the colder air. It's already dipping into the northern plains where temperatures are around the 0 degree mark. And these readings here, Minneapolis 13 degrees, Billings 6, they're about 15 to 20 degrees below normal. And this colder air is going to modify, but it will make it to Hampton Roads in northeastern North Carolina. With these storm systems rotating through and the cold air in place, that's going to give us the chance for a little bit of that rain snow mix as we head into Wednesday morning and early Wednesday afternoon. No rain or snow on the radar right now. Mostly clear skies, a lot of sunshine out there, and we'll see mostly clear skies tonight as well. Clouds will build in after midnight. Then as we take you through tomorrow morning, as you get up to go to work, it will be cold. Temperatures upper 20s, lower 30s, so you will need that heavier coat. And Tuesday afternoon, we're only looking at highs in the low to mid 40s, so colder than today. 12 o'clock, no rain out there, but by 5 o'clock, notice some rain showers start to pop up across northeastern North Carolina, maybe even some wet snowflakes, some sleet pellets mixing in from time to time. I don't think this is going to be a big impact on your evening commute. Notice that it is very short-lived and on the light side there. Then it will take a break, and by Wednesday morning, we're going to be tracking an area of low pressure, which will develop off the coast of Hatteras. So it will remain well offshore, and it's really not going to strengthen until it really moves well to the east of us. Therefore, we are going to get some wraparound moisture, but it's not going to be a lot. So scattered snow showers out there at 7 o'clock. Most of us above freezing. Some spots north of the metro may see temperatures hovering around the 32-degree mark. So we may see some minor accumulations, if that. Then at 10 o'clock, we see that rain starting to mix back in with that snow across the metro. Still showers across the Outer Banks. Some light snow showers across our northern zones, Northern Neck, Middle Peninsula, and the Peninsula. But keep in mind, the ground is still very warm. We've seen temperatures in the 60s for almost a week now. Wednesday at 12 o'clock in the afternoon, notice that the snow and the moisture really dying down, and then everything really gets out of here by 1, 2 o'clock. So by 5 o'clock, we're really not looking at anything but partly cloudy skies, so we may even see some sunshine to round out the day on Wednesday. Tomorrow, mostly cloudy. Afternoon, evening showers possible, rain showers, that is. 46 in Ahoskie, 45 in Edenton, 46 degrees in Elizabeth City, 45 Nagshead. Across the south side, a stray late afternoon evening shower possible, and you saw some of that pink on future track. We may see a few sleet pellets mix in. That's about it. 45 in Suffolk, 46 in Franklin, 46 degrees in Chesapeake, 44 in Norfolk and Virginia. Virginia Beach. So we are going to be even cooler tomorrow. 43 in Yorktown, 45 in Newport News, 43 in Pocosin. And it will be chilly along the eastern shore, highs in the lower 40s, 44 degrees around Gloucester. So we do have that slight chance for a late afternoon, early evening shower tomorrow. Better chances across North Carolina. Wednesday, we have that morning, early afternoon rain, snow mix. Minor accumulations possible, but a lot of us really not seeing anything sticking to the ground. Temperatures will be well above freezing. Keep that in mind. 40 degrees, 47 on Thursday. We're back down in the 30s on Friday. So that chilly weather, it'll stick around right through the weekend.
Many stories where information is still coming in. That's why you need to stick around for Wavy News 10 beginning at 5. I'm Tom Shad here in the newsroom, where we are following this weekend's murder of an ODU student, Erin Kelly. You heard her report a few moments ago. She spent her day digging into what happened Sunday morning in the moments leading up to the death of 20-year-old Paul Johnson. And also, walk with me for a moment into what we call an edit bay, where 10 on Your Side military reporter Art Kahn is still working on the big story of the day, one of the big stories, where Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel announced massive cuts, proposed cuts that really could affect Hampton Roads. He's listening to a tape right now and going through his notes. How these cuts affect Hampton Roads, Art's going to tell you more beginning at 5. And also, from Ghostbusters to Groundhog Day, we remember the work of Harold Ramis, a great actor, director, and artist of the silver screen. Join Nicole Ivas and me beginning on Wavy News 10 at 5.
Right now on Wavy News 10, some drivers ran into new traffic trouble morning in Portsmouth.
And big news, the longest serving member of Congress coming up next.
I got some, but I need some wheels.
Call Mac Jack, he got easy deals.
Get down with the dollar down.
I'm riding in a hoopty, I be hating.
Check Mac Mac, he don't sweat a credit rating.
No, he don't.
Federal experts predict Virginia could lose 68,000 jobs just due to Obamacare. Health premiums could triple. Washington politicians failed to stop Obamacare. Now the fight's in Richmond, and career politician Willie Randall supports Obamacare.
I'll protect the progress Barack Obama helped us make.
Willie Randall, higher premiums, fewer jobs.
This is Robert S. Bloxham, Jr., candidate for the House of Delegates. Bloxham for delegate, paid for this ad.
It's one sight that you'll never forget. It's horrible. You can't fathom what happened. Everybody here knew everybody that was in there. It's still on everybody's mind in town right now.
10 on Your Side helps keep a cold case alive. Tonight on Wavy News 10 at 6.
Next, E.T., Hollywood's paparazzi boycott.
I don't want strange men violating my child.
They're harassing celebrity kids. Plus, Priscilla Presley on a golf cart at Graceland.
Next, E.T.
Monday at 7 p.m. on Wavy TV 10.
On the next Access Hollywood, we are back from Sochi and bringing the most decorated female Olympic skier with us. Our candid conversation with the always fun Julia Mancuso. Next, Access Hollywood.
Monday at 7:30 p.m. on Wavy TV 10.
News doesn't end when the sun goes down.
So much can change. Breaking news happens. It's always something fresh, something new.
Coming on at 10 o'clock lets us develop more stories.
Your side has been working this story all night.
I want you to know what's going to be happening and how it will affect your life.
We're always working to tell your story.
That is what we strive to do every day.
WAVY News 10, every night at 10 and 11.
Things we really want to do with Wavy News 10 at 4 o'clock is to walk you through some of the things that are going on around the nation.
Yeah, and we're going to start right now with a big announcement from the longest serving member of Congress, Representative John Dingell of Michigan, says he's done.
Dingell, who is now 87 years old, was first elected to the House in 1955. That's when Dwight Eisenhower was president. Ooh. The congressman says that he talks about this with his wife every time an election comes up, but he says now is the time to let someone else represent his district.
A car crashed into a fire hydrant that soaked the streets in Southern California this morning. They say it never rains in Southern California, but when you have a gusher, it does. Water gushed into the area around 7 o'clock. The wet mess wasn't over, though. The car ended up in a car wash. The driver wasn't hurt. The area was shut down for several hours as crews stopped the gusher.
Check that out. There it goes, the Metrodome in Minneapolis. Well, sort of, anyway. A big blast took down part of the stadium yesterday. Many football fans say that this was one of the worst football stadiums ever built. You've been there, huh? And even though not everything came down, that was actually the plan. The Metrodome was home to the Minnesota Vikings for some 30 years. A new stadium will be ready in 2016.
But do you remember the snowstorm where it was sleeping
crash?
Yeah. Oh, we have amazing video. Look at that. From the skies to our south of a bird crashing into the cockpit.
Watch the Hampton Road Show at 11 a.m. on WAVY TV 10. Brought to you by Virginia's largest home store, Ashley Furniture Home Store.
History Bites, and you're going to love it.
Join us for a food tasting event of historic proportions March 8th.
Tickets on sale now at battleofhamptonroads.com.
We're always working to tell your story.
That is what we strive to do every day.
WAVY News 10, every night at 10 and 11.
Attention small business owners, it's your last chance on a great offer. Get the power and reliability of Verizon with our best speed available at your business location on high-speed internet and phone starting at $69.99 a month with a two-year agreement. Because with Verizon, you're not just ready, you're downloading huge files during the busiest part of the day without a hitch, ready. Your never-ending early morning conference call with a dozen participants, ready. You're checking inventory and juggling online orders, ready. Your small business ready. So switch to Verizon now. Call 1-888-610-8090 for your last chance to get consistently fast, high-speed internet and reliable phone with 99.9% network reliability starting at $69.99 a month with a two-year price guarantee. Plus an additional phone line included and a firm price quote up front of your total monthly charges for 2 years from Verizon. We put it in writing up front so there are no surprises. Call 1-888-610-8090 now to take advantage of this incredible last chance offer. Speed and reliability that makes you small business ready. That's powerful.
It's one sight that you'll never forget. It's horrible. You can't fathom what happened. Everybody here knew everybody that was in there. It's still on everybody's mind in town right now.
10 on Your Side helps keep a cold case alive. Tonight on WAVY News 10 at 6.
Next ET, Hollywood's paparazzi boycott.
I don't want strange men violating my child.
They're harassing celebrity kids. Plus, Priscilla Presley on a golf cart at Graceland.
Next ET.
Monday at 7 p.m. on WAVY TV 10.
On the next Access Hollywood, we are back from Sochi and bringing the most decorated female Olympic skier with us. Our candid conversation with the always fun Julia Mancuso. Next Access Hollywood.
Monday at 7:30 p.m. on WAVY TV 10.
Ten on Your Side is following a pair of stories that affect two really large groups in Hampton Roads, the military and college students.
Today, Defense Secretary Chuck Hagel announced a proposal that will shrink the size of the U.S. Army. He wants to bring down the number of active members somewhere between 440 and 450,000. That would be the lowest level since 1940. Currently, the troop level is 520,000. Hagel also wants to cut and replace an entire fleet of planes. If approved, the proposed plan would eliminate the A-10 Warthogs. The F-35 would replace it. This could save $3.5 billion over 5 years.
And our other big story we've been working all day is about the ODU student who died in a weekend attack. We just got brand new information into the WAVY newsroom. We're going to send it to Nicole Livas now for the very latest. Nicole?
Stephanie and Anita, we're just getting this statement within the last 15 minutes from Giovanna Gennard from Old Dominion University. It's a statement from the president, John Broderick, regarding the death of ODU student Paul Johnson. It basically says, words cannot express our shock and grief at the senseless loss of ODU student Paul Johnson. Such violence has no place in education, and the Old Dominion community will not tolerate it. I'm extremely grateful to the Norfolk Police and their joint investigative efforts with ODU Police that led to quick arrest of two suspects. I also want to acknowledge the many students who provided information and assistance to the investigation. Our work, however, does not and will not end here. The City of Norfolk and Old Dominion have pledged to work with the campus and neighboring communities to address issues of concern. Again, this statement from President John R. Broderick from Old Dominion University. Keep it here. Aaron Kelly will have more from campus on WAVY News 10 at 5. For now, Nicole Livas, WAVY News 10.
Thanks, Nicole. Tonight, police are searching for who knocked a bicyclist off track and to the ground. It happened over the weekend in Gloucester along Route 17 near Altrap Road. Police say the driver knocked Robert Gray off his bike and did not stop.
I'm Ann McNamara here in Gloucester, and I'm with Nikki Gray. She's the wife of RJ Gray. He was biking when he was run off Route 17, and Nikki would like to show you some of the things she believes helped kept him alive in this very dangerous accident. So, Nikki, can you show us the road ID first?
Well, a couple years ago, I bought RJ this road ID because he is a biker. He's been biking for about 10 years, and I wanted him to have something on his person because he usually doesn't carry an ID. I wanted him to have something on his person that would help people find us in case of an emergency where he was left unconscious. So this is his road ID, and it has information on it like your name, an emergency contact, and blood type and allergy information so that if there's any chance that you're unconscious, the ambulance would know any allergies that you might have, or if you needed blood, they'd know what type without having to do too much investigation and wasting time.
And in this case, this is how they contacted you.
This is how they found me. He was unconscious on the side of the road, and they were able to use the number to give me a call.
Okay, and how about the helmet? Show us what's happened to the helmet.
The helmet. RJ never leaves the house on his bike without a helmet. This is brand new. He's had it a month. Got it at Christmas time. And this helmet cracked at the points of impact, but this cage inside and all the padding kept everything intact on the inside part. It is cracked down on the inside, but his head was not cracked. He flipped over, took out the mirror on the truck, landed on the road, and got a mild concussion. There was no bleeding in his brain, just a little bit of external damage.
And you believe that teach the kids that this is why we wear the helmets.
Yes, our children are never ever allowed on their bikes without their helmets, and that's been the case since they had bikes. So,
and last thing we want to show you is his reflective coat. He was actually wearing this, and let's keep in mind that this accident happened about 1 p.m. So it was broad daylight, but still he's wearing the reflective jacket, and we can tell it's badly cut right there.
The material is made to prevent any cuts or scratches, and it did a really great job. He has one cut on his back, and it's where it tore on either a part of the truck or something on the ground, and he does have a nice cut right there in his skin, but all of this was protected from road rash or anything like that.
Okay. Nikki, thank you so much for sharing this information about safety. We're going to have more on RJ's story coming up on WAVY News 10 at 5 o'clock.
And thank you so much. Great information about wearing that helmet and reflective gear. It's very important. Now, we're going to take you back to the skies. We have sent a Chopper 10 live above what could become a new rush hour trouble spot. This is Route 58 at the London Boulevard exit in Portsmouth. Now, this morning, drivers coming off the Western Freeway who are used to taking that London exit found it was closed, and it's going to stay that way for up to a year. Doesn't look too bad yet. This is all part of the MLK extension project. And by the way, that's one of the projects you're paying tolls for at the tunnels. Now, Elizabeth River Tunnels is doing that work. And I talked with spokesperson Layla Rice this afternoon, and she told me that the reason for this backup on 58 this morning is because people are following their instincts and not the detour sign. So your instinct tells you to take a left turn on High Street to get you to London Boulevard, but the detour says go right. That'll take you down a few blocks and loop back around to London Boulevard. So they're hoping that with some new signage, people will understand that and it'll help get them to work earlier in the mornings. Again, usually a trouble spot probably in the mornings, more so.
the afternoons, but Chopper 10 is keeping an eye on it for you. Also coming up new tonight at 5:30, I talked to a gentleman, a homeowner in that neighborhood, being destroyed all around him to make way for progress. You'll hear from him. Well, Hampton Roads Transit wants to know how you want light rail to get to Naval Station Norfolk. Thursday at 4, we showed you a map of the 8 different possible routes to get to the world's largest naval base. Some would begin near Newtown Road or Military Highway, and some would track through Ghent and downtown. Tonight is the first of 3 public meetings on the Naval Station Norfolk Transit Study. And right now on the phone, we have Tom Holden from HRT. Tom, thank you for joining us on WAVY News 10 at 4.
You're welcome.
Hey, Tom, we got to ask, you know, you have these public meetings a lot. What can people expect when they go out there? A lot of people think, you know, why should I go out? They're not going to really listen to me. What happens?
This is a really important part of the process. These are workshops. They're not technically meetings. What we want are for the public to come out and sort of tell us what it is that they're interested in seeing in terms of connecting to the tide system. This study that is underway has 3 distinct phases. The first one helped us define what the purpose and need of this project is. You know, what problem are we trying to solve? The second phase defines what these alternatives might be. Is light rail the best, or is there some other option? And then tonight we're into phase 3. And this is how we refine the alternatives that have been proposed. And your map shows some of the ideas that the public have put down. We want to refine those a little bit tonight.
All right, Tom Holden with HRT. We appreciate it. We know you want to hear what the folks have to say. Everybody wants to make their commutes a little bit easier. And speaking of making commutes easier, let's send it over to Anita for some time saver traffic.
Yeah, I worked on that story last week about the new rail options, and there are definitely some opinionated people out there, so I'm sure that meeting will be interesting tonight. We're seeing some of your typical trouble spots for this time of the evening, specifically at the bridges and your overpasses where we're seeing some problems out there. As I zoom in here, I'm going to take you, the last time I was over on this side of the water, this time I'm going to take you over to the peninsula. If we're going to the HRBT here, you can see things are very slow as you're coming into the HRBT. This is off of 564 over there, 264. Now you can see at our different bridges how things, or our different tunnels, how things have slowed down to 5 and at most 9 minutes. So definitely you want to take it easy while you're out there and make sure that you pack a little extra time, because it is slow going when it comes to our tunnels especially. Now we have Tiffany Savona, who is outside giving us our forecast today.
And you will need those sunglasses when you are driving home. The sun, very bright, mostly sunny skies, not even a cloud outside of our WAVY studios here in Portsmouth. You're taking a look at our WAVY tower there in Super Doppler 10, which is quiet for right now, but that will be changing as we head into Tuesday and Wednesday. If you get home early from work and you want to take the dog for a walk, get some exercise in, temperatures are going to be dropping pretty quickly once the sun sets. So get out there before the sun does set. Temperatures will be down into the 40s. And if we can go over to the weather maps, we'll show you that express forecast for this evening. We're down into the 40s, 30s by midnight. And tomorrow's express forecast showing that we're only going to see highs in the 40s, but we're starting off in the 30s, some 20s for inland locations. So that cold stretch is going to continue. Plus, we have a rain snow mix. Yes, we could see some snow on Wednesday. We'll break it all down for you and show you when that storm system will move in with our future track model coming up in a couple of minutes.
Looks like you can use some sunglasses out there. Tiffany, thanks. Coming up new at 5, we are digging deeper and getting answers to questions surrounding the murder of an ODU student. Lots of questions about security and safety around campus. And you're going to hear what we found new at 5.
Plus, a temporary fix, at least for now, in the minefield of potholes on local highways. See what's being done and how you can help.
And a close call caught on tape. Watch for it. Hear from the pilot of the controls when that happened.
From the station on your side, you're watching WAVY News 10 at 4.
Federal experts predict Virginia could lose 68,000 jobs just due to Obamacare. Health premiums could triple. Washington politicians failed to stop Obamacare. Now the fight's in Richmond, and career politician Willie Randall supports Obamacare.
I'll protect the progress Barack Obama helped us make.
Willie Randall, higher premiums, fewer jobs.
This is Robert S. Bloxham, Jr., candidate for the House of Delegates. Bloxham for Delegate, paid for this ad.
Introducing great value from Assurance Wireless, a Lifeline assistance program. With our free talk and text plan, eligible households in Virginia receive a free cell phone, 250 free voice minutes, plus 250 free texts each month.
Now that I have Assurance, I can talk and text with no worries.
And if you need more, our $30 unlimited talk, text, and web plan offers a free phone plus unlimited minutes, text, and web for just $30 a month. Our plans are the best value among major Lifeline programs. Each plan provides nationwide coverage and these calling features.
With Assurance, I can keep in touch at home or on the go.
You may qualify if you're on Medicaid, food stamps, or certain other public assistance programs. Call now to see if you qualify for the best calling plans ever from Assurance Wireless.
Call 1-800-833-8333 or visit assurancewireless.com. That's 1-800-833-8333. 1-800-833-8333. Call today.
I got short money, but I need some wheels.
Call Mac Jack, he got easy deals.
Get down with the dollar down.
I'm riding in a hoopty, I be hating.
Check Mac Mac, he don't sweat a credit rating.
No, he don't.
Achieve their own dreams.
I'm waiting for Grace, and she showed up.
Yeah! NBC's The Voice premieres tonight, 8, 7 Central.
Tonight, I'm your plus one. You're not a cop tonight. You're a criminal. I feel like dancing.
NBC's The Blacklist returns tonight.
Welcome back, everybody. We're just getting in more responses now on the situation at ODU, a student who was killed over the weekend, and now we have a statement that just came out from the Norfolk Police Department.
Yeah, Norfolk Police say that they are going to heighten visibility in the area and provide Old Dominion University Police with additional resources to bolster safety within that community. Yeah. So a quick
working
response.
Hand in hand with ODU's security there on campus.
All right, and again, Erin Kelly is working on new information. She's getting answers to a lot of your questions. Mm-hmm. Look for her report coming up in just about 20 minutes at 5 o'clock.
Yeah. We do have an amazing piece of video that we want to show you. It showed up on the feeds this morning.
This is a really rare moment that was caught on video. Take a look. Whoa, did you see that?
Yeah.
That was a bird. This actually happened Saturday near Fort Myers. Look, again, near Fort Myers, Florida, just a few miles from touching down. It was flying at 170 miles per hour when that happened.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah. Safe back on the ground, pilot Rob Weber talked about the impact.
A few seconds later, all of a sudden the windshield just exploded and stuff was flying everywhere. And I wasn't sure if the bird was in the plane with me, where he was, or what was happening.
It was.
I don't know if you noticed right there on the top of his head, he did get cut on his head there.
Well, you saw that glass fly in.
Yeah,
yeah,
absolutely. He just installed that camera, by the way, a few weeks ago.
Wow. Install the camera, you get what you wanted. A voice from right here in Hampton Roads is hoping to make it big in front of everyone in America. See the local girl who hopes to do well on NBC's The Voice.
I've heard her. She's incredible.
Okay, so here are two laptops. This one can download an HD TV show in 10 seconds. This one takes over 45 seconds. Which laptop is better?
This one, definitely.
This one.
It's kind of a no-brainer.
Actually, they're the exact same laptop.
Wow.
The only difference is this is on Cox Internet, and this is on Fios Quantum Internet.
Quantum takes the cake.
That looks lightning fast.
Gives me a little bit of a rush.
Your technology is only as good as the network it's on, and Fios is America's fastest, most reliable network.
See the difference for yourself and upgrade to a Fios Triple Play online for just $89.99 a month with a 2-year price guarantee and no annual contract. Plus, get a free speed upgrade to 50 meg internet for 2 years and switch with the contract. confidence of a worry-free guarantee. Verizon Fios is 100% fiber optic. Cox isn't. That's why nothing compares to Fios. Rated number one by PC Magazine 7 years in a row for speed, reliability, and customer satisfaction. Upgrade to Fios today and go to Verizon.com/superfast to get America's fastest, most reliable internet. Getting the difference? That's powerful.
Packed like sardines in there.
Don't they know drive time can help?
Go get them.
Hi, this is where you get off.
Let's get you some wheels.
Oh, I can't afford that.
Drive time's new low price lease. You can't afford
not to get a car.
What? I can't believe you said that.
It's like you live in here.
Really good. It's like, oh,
save yourself. Everybody drives with a cancel anytime lease. Only at Drive Time. Call, click, or visit.
It's one sight that you'll never forget. It's horrible. You can't fathom what happened. Everybody here knew everybody that was in there. It's still on everybody's mind in town right now.
10 on Your Side helps keep a cold case alive. Tonight on WAVY News 10 at 6.
I want to help someone else achieve their own dreams.
I'm waiting for Grace, and she showed up.
Yeah! NBC's The Voice premieres tonight, 8, 7 Central.
Tonight, I'm your plus one. You're not a cop tonight. You're a criminal. I feel like dancing.
NBC's The Blacklist returns tonight.
Welcome back to WAVY News 10 at 4. Chopper 10 flying high above Hampton Roads, bringing you all the breaking news.
Oh, great shot right there. As we can see, the skies are clear today, but we do have some things that are changing. Our team of meteorologists are working on your forecast. We're also working on what's happening on your roadways down below, and we'll have an update on that coming up.
And what's trending? Let's check it out with Nicole Livis.
I'm Nicole Livis in the Hampton Road Show studio. Here are the top stories trending right now on WAVY.com. First of all, the story we've been talking about a lot today, ODU student murder, and proposed Army budget cuts, also traffic cameras. You can always head over to WAVY.com for the very latest. Another popular story on our website, a local singer's appearance on tonight's season premiere of NBC's The Voice. Smithfield High School student Bria Kelly sang James Taylor's Steamroller Blues. She had the crowd roaring, and all four coaches turned around. Check out this sneak peek here. The judges not only gave her a standing ovation, Usher said, "Ladies and gentlemen, we have just heard The Voice." Sounds like she's got a great start on the TV talent show. Now, if Bria looks familiar to you, you may have seen her when she competed on America's Got Talent 2 years ago. She also spent time right here in this studio in November 2012 during Live Music Friday on the Hampton Roads Show. Here's a clip from then. Isle of Wight County School spokesperson Kenita Bowers tells us Bria is also a songwriter, and she performed at various venues, including Nashville's Cadillac Ranch and CMA's Music Fest. Count on us to follow Bria Kelly's progress on The Voice. And as for the NBC hit show itself, Shakira and Usher are back in the coaches' chairs, hoping to build a strong team and looking for their first voice win against former champs Adam Levine and Blake Shelton. In the Hampton Roads studio, Nicole Livis, 10 on Your Side.
Going to be a good show tonight. Can't wait to watch that. I heard Bria when she was like that big singing the national anthem. Incredible big voice for a little girl. Well, here's some more good news. Good news from VDOT. Pothole season is upon us. Okay, that's not the good news. Actually, the good news is VDOT's fixing them. Crews will be all over the state patching up the potholes. And now keep in mind that these are only temporary fixes because you just never know what kind of winter weather will hit during March. The permanent fixes come when the weather warms up for real. Still, VDOT wants to hear from you. You can report on the agency's website or call 1-800-4-ROAD, F-O-R, ROAD. That's an easy number, but we'll repeat it, 1-800-4-ROAD. Now, if you have a favorite pothole, one you love to hate in your neighborhood, there's info to report that right here on WAVY.com. Just type pothole in the search box at the top of our homepage. The stories you'll find listed with that keyword have the phone numbers of your community so that you can report those potholes.
I saw them out fixing the one that took out my tire over the weekend. So glad to see that things are being fixed out there. We do want to continue to update you on what's happening on your roadways. We're also looking at what's happening with your forecast, though, because we have some big changes in store.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's why they're not going to permanently fix those potholes, right?
I know. There's always that really big one they always try to avoid, and then there's ones, down the road from
clunk,
there.
Clunk.
So, right. And the reason really why these potholes keep appearing is because temperatures keep going below 32 degrees. And it's looking like we're in for another cold spell as we head into this upcoming work week. I know a lot of folks don't want to hear that. Spring begins March 20th, so we still got a couple weeks of winter to endure. Now, notice that last week, here are your high temperatures. We were down in the 30s last Monday, and then we saw temperatures back up in the 60s Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. We broke a record on Friday. That was just shy of 80 degrees, I should say. And now this week, we topped out in the lower 50s today. And then notice that Tuesday, we're going to be back down around 40 degrees, 40s on Wednesday, back down into the 30s as we head on into Thursday and Friday. So a much cooler week expected as we head into the next couple of days. But a beautiful Monday out there. We're looking at lots of sunshine, not even a cloud in the sky. Temperatures really all over the place depending on where you are. 59 degrees currently in Newport News. And you've had a northwesterly, more of a westerly breeze. Look at those gusts up to 25 at times, helping to warm you up. But places close to the water like Norfolk, you've actually seen winds off the water out of the east and northeast. And the water temperature only in the lower 40s. So that's why Norfolk, Virginia Beach struggling to make it to 50. Portsmouth at 57. We're at 59 in Chesapeake, 48 in Hampton with a northeasterly breeze, 56 in Suffolk, and 57 in Williamsburg. So about a 10-degree difference for those areas inland, a little bit warmer. Our future track model showing mostly clear skies overnight. There will be some clouds that will roll in by 7 o'clock tomorrow morning. Temperatures tomorrow morning, upper 20s, lower 30s. It is going to be a very cold start to the day. You'll likely need that heat overnight. Then by tomorrow, by noon, mostly cloudy. Temperatures only in the lower 40s. And then by 5 o'clock, scattered showers possible across North Carolina. We may see a few snowflakes, sleet pelts mix in from time to time, but temperatures are going to be above freezing. So none of this should stick, and it will be on the light side. Then we'll take things into Wednesday. So the precipitation really starts to let up Tuesday night. By Wednesday morning, there it is, an area of low pressure forming off the coast of the Outer Banks. And it's really not going to strengthen until it moves well to the northeast of us. So we're going to be on the backside of all this moisture. Not a lot of moisture out there, but there will be enough for scattered rain showers across the metro. We could see that rain snow mix, and then areas from the peninsula up northward for the middle peninsula, northern neck, eastern shore, you have a better chance for seeing that snow. That's where temperatures could be right around the freezing mark. So we may see some minor accumulations, but it's not looking that likely because the ground is so warm. 12 o'clock, just some stray snow showers out there, and that's about it. Things really start to end by 1-2 o'clock in the afternoon, and we may even see the sunshine by 5 o'clock before it does set, with temperatures down into the 40s. So here's Wednesday's storm. It's not going to be a big event for us. Most of that snow will melt on contact, as temperatures will be above freezing. We may see minor accumulations north of the peninsula on grassy surfaces and decks. Keep in mind the ground is still very warm. So tomorrow we're going to see highs in the middle 40s, mostly cloudy. Afternoon, evening showers possible across North Carolina. Stray afternoon, evening showers across the south side. And we should say dry across the peninsula and points northward with temperatures in the 40s. Now your 7-day forecast showing that morning rain snow mix on Wednesday, 40 degrees. Then we'll see those upper 30s on Friday. And during this 4 o'clock newscast, meteorologist Don Slater has been behind the scenes working on something special that you'll see at 5. Don?
Well, we're going to take a look at where everything is really kind of hitting at us. Weather systems are taking shape to our west, and they're going to move on through. Now, you can see a wide view of things, some snow way on off to the northwest, and you can see things moving on through. We're going to really hone in on our area and show you what's going to be going on specifically for us, other than the fact that there's sunshine right now. But we'll show you exactly what we're looking at for us. It'll be coming up on Wavy News 10 at 5, so stay with us for that.
Okay, we'll see you soon, Don. We get information for our stories from a lot of different sources, including Facebook. So take a good look at this picture right here. Up next, A local teen's positive message is getting a big response online and on the streets. You don't want to miss that.
And also coming up new at 5, the price to go to one Virginia university is about to get a lot more expensive. Find out where.
Man, this traffic is bad. I could be sitting here all day.
That's right. Traffic.
What the?
But isn't it more enjoyable to have someone to share the ride with?
Yeah, and it saves money, too. What? Where the?
Not to mention lowering congestion and helping the environment.
Plus, you get some great rewards. Just sign up at GoTraffix.com.
Find your match at GoTraffix.com. Carpool, vanpool, get great rewards. Visit GoTraffix.com.
Are there any more people showing up?
Bingo!
Darn it. I was one square away from winning that game.
It's a shame Sadie isn't here today. She always wins. Could have won the big prize.
You know, that could have helped her with some of Jim's funeral expenses.
There wasn't any life insurance?
No, there wasn't. I'd been trying to convince her to call about the Colonial Penn program to make sure they had coverage. But she was worried they wouldn't be accepted because of their health.
I have life insurance with them, too. I had concerns, but I didn't have to take a physical or even answer any health questions. My acceptance was guaranteed.
Well, I should get some life insurance for myself. I'm kind of on a fixed budget, though. I don't know if I can afford it.
I thought the same thing. It works out to be about 35 cents a day. That's just $9.95 a month per unit of coverage.
I think I can afford that. I'm going to give them a call.
And now you can help protect your loved ones from the burden of your final expenses with a guaranteed acceptance whole life insurance policy through the Colonial Penn program. In today's world, uncertainty seems to be the new norm. With life insurance through the Colonial Penn program, there is no uncertainty. If you're age 50 to 85, your acceptance is guaranteed. You don't have to answer any health questions or take a medical exam. You cannot be turned down because of your health. For $9.95 a month per unit of coverage, you can take an important step toward protecting your loved ones. You can have affordable quality insurance at a rate which is guaranteed to never go up. Call about the Colonial Penn program now and let a representative help you get started.
G47.
Bingo!
Take an important step toward protecting your family by calling 1-800-376-3030 for free information and a free gift. Or visit cpdirect.com. 1-800-376-3030. A chilling murder mystery haunting a small town. Tonight at 6.
We're back on Wavy News 10 at 4 with an image from a 10 on Your Side viewer that caught our attention. Look closely here. Someone posted this picture on our Facebook page and says that this teen frequently stands on the corner of Kempsville and Providence in Virginia Beach. Now, the teen, as you can see, is holding a sign. She has a Facebook page called Stay Six Positive. The message she's holding says, "My name is Carson and I've been bullied all my life. I let this affect me all my life. Until now. September 2013, someone said something to me that completely changed my perspective. I told myself I wouldn't let the words get to me anymore. I would take a stand, not only for me, but for the people who are afraid or could not. Every day I get the chance, I stand on the corner of a busy intersection by my house and hold up signs, hoping to pass on the positive energy, make a stranger smile, or get that person to think. Well, a lot of people like her message. Way to go. And now we take a live look at our Wavy newsroom, where everyone is working together to bring you new information. During the next 90 minutes, Wavy News 10 continues now at 5.